Sri Lankans are living under a shadow of fear. A state of emergency is in place, but more attackers could be on the run. A total of 40 suspects have been detained so far. Footage of a suspected bomber has now emerged. The pictures on your screens were captured on a CCTV camera. The suspect can be seen walking towards a church in Negombo with a backpack. So far, the National Tawheed Jamaat was being blamed for the attack. This is an offshoot of the Sri Lanka Tawheed Jamaat, a group known for its hatred against Buddhists. The National Tawheed Jamaat was a little-known terrorist group until now. They were in the news last year when several Buddha statues were vandalized in central Sri Lanka. Now they are being linked to ISIS. Sri Lankan Prime Minister Vikramasinghe today said that the Islamic State has indeed expanded its footprint in the country. He said the Sri Lankan intelligence agencies were tracking some individuals who may be linked to the terror group.
They feel that some of them have traveled abroad and come back. There may be more than that. That's what we want to find, and that's why we've asked for assistance on this issue. Some countries, anyway, have to conduct their own investigations because their nationals were killed in this blast.
But events in the last 2 days have only widened the differences in the Sri Lankan government. It's no secret. Sri Lanka was warned about these attacks, but they refused to act. The Prime Minister blames the President. He claims that no one in the cabinet knew about these intelligence warnings. Last year, Ranil Wickremesinghe and the Sri Lankan President Maithripala Sirisena fought a bitter political war for power. Sri Lanka is now paying a heavy price for that. And India cannot afford to ignore the situation in Sri Lanka, our immediate neighbour. The attack happened in India's own backyard. In fact, Indian agencies had warned Sri Lankan authorities about this threat weeks before Sunday. If the claims by the Islamic State are indeed true, their presence, the presence of ISIS in Sri Lanka on such a scale, hurts Indian security interests. It is indeed alarming. Which is why National Investigation Agency, the NIA, wants to send a team to Colombo. Reports say that they're likely to move a request with the Home Ministry for this visit. The NIA wants to study these blasts. Sri Lanka has not seen an attack of such a scale since the civil war ended in 2009. The emergence of a new terror force could impose a danger to Indian investments and the security apparatus in Sri Lanka. India's tip-offs to the Sri Lankan authorities also prove that it can assist Colombo with the investigation. India has proved to be a reliable source for intelligence. The strategic relationship between these two countries goes back many decades. Experts do not rule out the involvement of Indian officials and agencies in the investigation. Sri Lanka has already reached out to foreign agencies for help. The FBI is among them.